What's going on, guys? So three instructor. This video is over field expedient shooting rests, and this video is going to be a series of different shooting rests. But this first series covers this is going to be something that you can make as far as the front of the rifle setting in this. Basically, all I did was I took a piece of I think it was half inch plywood. As you can see, I'm spreading my hand on it. You can see how big it is. You can make this as big or, I guess, whatever you want. You can make it to where you can bolt a tripod mount on here. So you can put this on a tripod, take it on and off. You can also make it to where you can put straps through here so you can attach it to a pack. And you can keep it on the outside of your pack at all times. And so, you know, if you're hunting, you lay down your pack, set your rifle in there, and this is a lot better than just using your pack alone, because this will keep the gun from canting, you know, back and forth, and also rocking side to side. All I did was after I cut the half inch piece of plywood into a rectangle, I took two layers of this isomat material, which is a foam type material. And I cut those two rectangles out, put them on there, put a layer of duct tape over it, and then I just built it up layer by layer by layer by layer by layer until I got the height that I was comfortable with. And I done it on both sides. And obviously you're gonna have to cut that rectangle right there out and stack those until you get your height. Very simple to do. Use rigger's tape, isomat foam, and then just a piece of plywood at the bottom to make it solid and it doesn't bend. I guess you could make this out of all isomat, but it wouldn't be sturdy, you know. All right, the next field expedient shooting rest you can use is you can use a sock. And what I like to do, I like to have two socks. One would be a black sock on the outside, one on the inside, just be an old sock that I have, and I fill it with rice because rice is usually something that you can find a lot of. If you want to, you can use sand. You know, I don't see nothing wrong with that, but I just prefer rice. Now, you can use a rubber band here, you can use a zip tie, you can use a piece of 5 feet cord, a piece of rope. Just remember, the looser you have it, the more this will be easier to form to whatever butt stock or the fore end, whatever you're going to set on this, it'll actually conform to it. But if you have it real tight, it's going to have a harder time conforming to it. And with my type of rest like this, I like for the gun to be able to kind of, you know, indent itself in there. I found that it's a little bit steadier and it's a little bit more accurate for me. So on that, all you need is two socks and, you know, and you're good to go. If you want to put two or three extra socks over this to protect it, you can if you want. I mean, I don't see nothing wrong with it. But I like to have a sock, a very, very long tube sock. That way I can move my tie point down and make it as tight or firm or as loose as I want it. All right, and that got that. All right, thanks, guys.